We interrupt your regularly scheduled brainwashing in order to bring you news, breaking news. A special segment of the Almost Daily Zencast, focused on curious, quirky, and quixotic news items that you may have missed during the last 48-hour news cycle. Hosted by me, the incorrigible Mr. Zeppo.
Hello, and thank you for tuning in for a special episode of News Breaking News. I wanted to share with you my personal favorite quote from today's special committee hearing interrogating FBI agent Strozek. How do you pronounce that? And also, did anyone ask him, is your last name a Russian last name? Because it looks like a Russian last name. But that's, I'm just being funny. I digress. I wanted to play for you, without any permission, from C-SPAN, the best that I think, and I didn't see all of it, but from the big chunks of the interviews, or rather the committee hearing and the questions being posed, out of everything I heard today on C-SPAN, this is my favorite passage because I think it's the most salient set of points made. Congressman Gutierrez uses his 5 minutes exceptionally well. So just tune into what he's got to say here. It's actually quite fascinating and poignant, and I think that everyone in Trumptopia needs to hear it. And I'm sharing it with you because I've noticed I haven't seen this clip played on any of the media today. Maybe I missed it. I don't have enough time in the world to listen to all the media everywhere, but it seems like the kind of clip that ought to be at the forefront of the coverage, and it's not. They've picked other things. But here is for you my favorite passage of today's Oversight Committee hearing featuring Congressman Gutierrez.
Chair now recognizes the gentleman from Illinois, Mr. Gutierrez, for 5 minutes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. The chairman started this hearing by saying, I wish this hearing wasn't necessary. Well, sorry if I don't believe that. Of course, he wants this hearing, and it isn't necessary. Now, I think there are hearings that are necessary, and we see them every day. There are 3,000 children separated from their moms and dads, and the government doesn't know where their moms and dads are and can't even bring them together. That seems like something the Judiciary Committee should be investigating. We start a policy in this country where we ban Muslims from coming in, and we make a test, a religious test. Sounds to me like something the Judiciary Committee should take up. We have a president of the United States. There are 16 women who have come forward to say that the president of the United States has attacked them. And what does the committee do? No hearings. Even one of the members of this committee had to resign in disgrace because he asked one of his staffer for $1 million if she would carry a baby for him. Do we have any hearings on the state and the plight of women in the workplace in America? No. These are all things and issues that are on the American people's minds. We don't want to talk about those issues. Those should be issues that I believe are pertinent and should have hearings before this committee. But what we want to have hearings is to bring Mr. Strzok here so that we can regurgitate and continue to say that he is lying and that he is biased and somehow he corrupted the investigation to the point that we can't believe Mr. Mueller, that we can't believe Mr. Rosenstein, that we can't believe the new FBI director who was appointed by the current president of the United States, and that we should abandon. My members on the other side, if there are two people that are thrilled and excited today, there are two people. The folks over over at Fox News and at the Kremlin. Because they both worked on one thing, electing President Trump, President of the United States of America. They've got to be overjoyed today at the Kremlin, and they've got to be applauding. And watch the newsreel tonight. Because a lot of this today is simply what? Auditioning for Fox News. And, of course, at the clapping at the Kremlin. I never thought I would see a time that the Congress of the United States would do the work of destroying. Because what do we know? We know very clearly that our men and women of the intelligence community have unanimously stated, and this is unrefutable, that the Russians work to undermine our democracy and to elect Donald Trump President of the United States. And that is something that's irrefutable. You can say what you want about Mr. Strzok, that's irrefutable. And yet we do not investigate that. How can we have such an attack on our democracy and we don't investigate? But we want to investigate Mr. Strzok. So I want to ask you, Mr. Strzok, because they've kept saying you have this bias. When did you learn and how did you learn about the investigation into the possible collusion between the Donald Trump campaign and Russian influence in our 2016 election?
Sir, I'm limited to what Director Comey was authorized to say by the Department of Justice, but in late July.
So in late July. And when did the public learn about the investigation into Russian collusion and Donald Trump's investigation?
I don't remember a specific date, but it was well into the following year.
It was after the election?
Yes, sir.
So what we're to believe from our Republican majority that you're so biased, you're such a Democrat that you can't hold back from trying to destroy Donald Trump. Yet you never told anybody that there was an investigation into Donald Trump's campaign and collusion with the Russians. You never told anybody about that?
No, sir.
You never talked to a reporter about that?
Never.
But you had it in your hands. Well, maybe you didn't because, you know, in America, so you could do almost anything. But you did have almost a magical bullet in your hand to derail the Donald Trump investigation. And did you use it?
No, sir.
No, you didn't, right? Are there Republicans that work at the FBI? Because it makes it sound like you're all Democrats. I never heard that before, but are there Republicans?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What would be interesting here is, since you like to cherry pick the Democrats that given money, the FBI agents that give money to Democrats, why don't you reveal the Republican members of the FBI that give money to Republicans? Why don't you reveal the Republican members of the FBI that are in and state very clearly when they apply for a voter registration, they apply as Republicans. They don't. Because that's not what this is about. What this is about is for the American public, Mr. Strzok, it's really not about you. They want to damage and destroy our democracy. And one of the ways they do it is by taking an institution like the FBI and destroying it. And that, I think, is really regrettable. Okay, Kremlin, another good day for you. You influenced the election. You wanted Donald Trump to win. You won that one. And now you want to destroy our institutions. Congratulations, Kremlin. And congratulations to everybody that's helping them.
Wasn't that an amazing bit of political theater? Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not a Republican. I'm not a Democrat. And that hearing was nothing but pure political theater. But at least Gutierrez gave a great speech, a great Shakespearean monologue about the audacity and the blatant, bold-faced hypocrisy of the GOP and how they are unwilling to investigate so many other serious issues. Now, of course, we have to be fair and point out that none of the Democrats have rallied a cry to investigate those things either. But that's easy to overlook. Thanks again for tuning in to a mini episode of News Breaking News. Please tune in to other segments like Good Morning Trumptopia and the Almost Daily Zencast for a broader picture at my political socioeconomic thesis about what the fuck is wrong with the world. Until next time, this has been your snarky-ass host, the incorrigible Mr. Zeppo. By the way, that audio was recorded off of C-SPAN without permission whatsoever. If they sue me, I'll stop doing it. But I'm not doing it to screw with C-SPAN. I'm doing it to help wake people up to the bullshit of political ideology.
And that is the latest news breaking news. We now return you to your regularly scheduled brainwashing. Thank you for listening.